Oh, well done. Well done.
Thank you very much. Thanks to you. Thanks to everybody here. Thank you. That was my last day on the Big Breakfast, and what a great way to finish. That was good.
That was good. Fantastic drive. But the best part about racing is spraying the champagne at the end.
Have you got any?
Well done.
Thank you, Eugene. Listen, I couldn't possibly spray this on you. You've been so nice to me all day. Sean? Sean?
Now then, young man.
Oh, Tommy Savile.
Young man, you did a grand job.
Thank you very much.
And I've got to tell you that I'm going to do it in my own voice. Did you know that you completed that lap in just 1 minute 44 seconds? And the quickest time for the circuit in a car like that is 1 minute 31.
Wow. That's all right then.
You were so close.
13 seconds up.
And there we go. A gavel fix it badge.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Thank
well
you,
done.
Tommy Savile.
Long. Lovely. Right, coming up very, very shortly.
You're going to be doing
shortly.
This for 21 years now.
Okay. No. I could do some marathons though, maybe. Coming up very shortly, we're going to go back to Keith. Who runs marathons?
No, I know.
Oh, yeah. We're going back to Keith Chegwin and Lennox Lewis. That's going to be coming up later, but straight after the break, where you can win your very own car in Glug Glug. Guess who spilt the milk?
Guess who spilt the milk? With a glug glug here, a glug glug there, here a bug, there a bug, everywhere a bug. Guess who spilt the milk? Guess who spilt the milk?
Guess who spilt the milk? And guess what? We've only got half a cow.
Aww.
We've only got half a cow.
Aww.
In fact, here's the cow's rump in my hand. And the only reason we've got half a cow is because we're doing this earlier than normal, and Sheridan, little Shed, our graduate trainee, is late and he's here, in fact, now.
Come on, Shed.
Come on, Shed.
Be the rump. Anyway, this is our cow, Pat. We're playing for a car. As always, you can win a car if you're on the phone now. There's a beautiful little car. And who's on line one? Hello.
Hello.
Hello, who are you?
I'm Cher.
Cher?
Yeah.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Goodness me. It was lovely working with you.
Hi, Chris. How are you?
No, it really is Cher. Oh, goodness me. Cher, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Oh, just great. Cher, where are you?
I'm in my bed. I'm in London, and I'm in my bed.
Whereabouts in London are you?
I'm in my bed in London. That's about as close as you're going to get.
You know I wanted more information than that. I finish at 9. I can be around at 10. So, have you been watching the show?
No, actually, somebody just woke me up.
Oh, Cher!
Oh!
Cher!
What are you doing in England?
Well, I'm going to be over here spending some time next year, so I came over to get a flat.
Did you? I'm sure you won't have any trouble getting a flat.
No.
Hello, could I have a flat, please? So, is Cher going to play the game, or are we just chatting?
No, we're just chatting, because I know you're leaving, so I just called to say hello.
Oh, well, thank you. Most of the people are saying goodbye, and you're saying hello. That's nice.
That's nice.
It? Lovely. Will we see you on Don't Forget Your Toothbrush again this year?
Well, I think so.
Yay!
Okay, great. And I do understand you're also making a record with Jules Holland, aren't you?
Well, actually, I've been working with Jules, He was kind of responsible for this record happening over in London, so he's really terrific. And I met him on your show.
Yeah, you did. So it's all good people come together in the end. Yeah. Well, okay, we got to go now, Cher. Thanks for calling, though.
I hope you do all the things that you want to do when you leave here.
I've done most of them already. Okay, well, thanks a lot, Cher.
Bye.
Well, they said it was Cher. I thought, isn't life strange? Who is on line one? Hello.
Away.
Who's that now?
It's Chris from Nottingham. Hello.
Oh, never mind, Chris. How does it feel being the second caller to Cher?
Brilliant.
Does it? Okay, good. Okay, you want to win a car?
Definitely.
Okay, I thought Cher could have played the competition, because she could do with the car, poor love. we're going to play a film. If you watch this film, we're going to ask you an observational question about the film. If you get that observational question right, then you qualify to guess who spilt the milk, guess the identity of our secret person disguised in the film, all right?
Okay.
You get that question wrong, we ask somebody else a question, give them a chance to win the car. Watch the film, and all the other callers on the line, watch the film too, because we share this film only
once!
Guess who spilt the milk?
Mm-hmm.
thinking it, you celebrities just can't hang on to your milk.
Guess who spilt the milk? Guess who spilt the milk?
Would you open the door if your milkman looked like that? I certainly wouldn't. Right, so you've got to tell us, first of all, the answer to this question. The milkman had a number of milk bottles in his crate. How many were in his crate? Were there 12, 9, or 7?
7.
7 is your answer, and 7 is... Well, let's have a look if it's right, shall we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is 7, yes!
Yay!
Okay, so you now qualify to guess who spilt the milk in the milkman's face. If you get this right, you win the car. If you don't, we go on to our next caller. What's your answer?
Angela Rippon.
Angela Rippon, for a car?
Yeah.
You've just won a car.
Yes!
Okay. That's the car that you've won, and once again, our thanks to Angela, who we love and know dearly.
God.
Well, I have to come clean. It was me. I spilt the milk all over that lovely milkman, Terry. Oh. I promise I won't do it again.
We love Ange. We love Ange, and you love Ange, because you'll never forget her, because she won you a car.
Yay!
Okay, what? And it's worth £6,000, apparently, that car. Okay, but once again, as I said yesterday, I look much taller off television than I do. I won't bother. Okay, well, thanks, thanks, Cal. Won't see you again. This is sad. Okay, I'm sad to leave the front end, but not so sad to leave the back end. Still to come, Lennox Lewis is with Keith Chegwin now, live. And we're going to be going back to them soon. We've got a big surprise for Lennox. But before that, a little question about a little clip. By the way,
it was
still watching. Name this dance, but don't phone. It's just for fun.
Welcome back to Chris's Lost Show on the Big Break. Mm. The question was, name that dance, the fish slapping dance. And that was from the totally fantabulous Monty Python's Place Out. It's out to buy on video now to coincide with their 25th anniversary next week. And that's clips from Series 3, Volumes 1 and 2, price $12.99.
Yeah, why didn't they show the bit of that clip where he falls in the water?
Yeah.
Did it in the first part? Oh, I was talking to Cher backstage.
Yeah, yeah. Present time.
What?
Present time.
My present goes with Anna from Makeup's present.
Okay.
Which is a bit of a surprise. Well,
you have
thank
to do
you,
Anna's
Anna.
First.
Anna's first. Anna, I love you. Thank you very much indeed.
And read what it says.
Anna makes me look half decent every day. For the man who has everything. Okay.
It's actually ours.
What?
Like mine and Anna's.
Oh, I know what it is! It's an underwired bra! Yay! Is that Wonder Bra?
And that's one of mine, though.
Underwired.
Yeah.
Is it?
I don't need a Wonder Bra, Chris.
Check this. It's big.
We've got to go to the news. I'll open this straight after the news. Okay? Here's the news with Peter.
Top stories this morning. Rescue vessels and helicopters are continuing the search for survivors from yesterday's Baltic ferry disaster as hopes fade of finding anyone alive. No more survivors were found overnight. 781 people are still missing. Scottish electricity users could save £300 million over the next 3 years. A review of Scotland's power prices by electricity watchdogs means Scottish power users will save £91 and Scottish hydroelectric users £74. The British couple accused of trying to smuggle a baby out of Romania are being put through hell, according to their family. After a third trial postponement, relatives of Adrian and Bernadette Mooney have called on the Bucharest court to show compassion. A telephone hotline is paying off in the fight against water pollution. The National Rivers Authority says hundreds are reporting firms who pour toxic waste into lakes and rivers, and water pollution is down. Now the weather dry and mild in the east and south, showers elsewhere. Temperatures around 15 centigrade, 59 Fahrenheit. Glasgow has the highest chance of rain. 8:41, we're back at 9. Here's Chris and Gabby.
Thank you very much, Peter.
And Mandy's here as well. And Paula.
Yeah.
Mandy!
Everybody's here.
Just in case you want to stop wearing your usual underwear.
Are these yours?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.